Hello students, and welcome to our lecture about relationship marketing. In this lecture, our objectives are to understand the definition of relationship marketing and the evolution of this approach, the difference between the transactional or the traditional marketing and the relationship marketing. Also, we will discuss the relationship marketing advantages and also the tools which can enable us to achieve the relationship marketing objectives. So first of all, what is relationship marketing? As you know, the traditional marketing, which depend on the sales approach, or we call the transactional approach, is only caring about selling the product to customer and getting cash or profit to the organization. But in the relationship marketing, our main objective is to engage our customer in a long-term relationship. Also, through the relationship marketing strategies, we keep a satisfying and long-term relationship with all the parties involved in the sales and marketing areas, like customers, suppliers, distributors, in order to retain a long-term performance for our business. We can define relationship marketing simply as a strategy designed to foster customer loyalty, interaction, and long-term engagement. So, why did the strategies and the approach of relationship marketing evolved in the first place? If you look at any market today, you will see a very strong and fierce competition. The market also has become a global market. We have a very short product life. Look at any mobile or tablet. The consumer is changing his needs and desires and proposition in a very quick way. That's why, to keep your customer satisfied, you have to engage your customer and have them acting as advocates for your product. Therefore, you can see that relationship marketing is shifting from the traditional transactional marketing to a new way to engage the customer for better performance. Of course, the goals of relationship marketing includes customer acquisition, customer satisfaction, retention of the customers, and enhancing the customer base. If we compare between the traditional or transaction marketing and relationship marketing, you can see that in the former, it focuses on a single sale, and in the relationship marketing, we focus on customer retention and long-term relationship. Meantime, in the transactional marketing, you focus on product features which you provide to your customer. On the other hand, in the relationship marketing, you focus on the product benefits to the customer. Segmentation in the traditional marketing and in the relationship marketing is very obvious. In the transactional marketing, we used to do segmentation based on demographic, geographic, or any other criteria, but in the relationship marketing, you focus mainly on the benefit to customers, and it has become more personal segmentation. The normal 4 P's, which we used to discuss in our marketing mix in the traditional marketing, which are product, price, promotion, and place, now you have the 4 C's, a modified set of marketing mix The product has been changed to consumer solution. Price now is a consumer cost. The place is a consumer convenience, and promotion is the communication with the consumer. Of course, the advantage is clear. You focus on providing value to your customer. You emphasize on customer retention. You are trying to achieve competitive advantage and long-term loyalty from your customer to beat your competitors. Therefore, you can expect to have your customer being less price sensitive and more likely to talk favorably about your product or act as advocate to your product. The word of mouth marketing, more likely to refer product to other, more likely to refer your products to other and remain loyal for a long time. If you remember the product level of Kotler, we used to call the basic functions of the product, we call the core benefit. And in the transactional marketing, you may focus on the core benefit and the generic product, but in the relationship marketing, you are focusing on the augmented level, which include improved customer service, warranty, and customer relation management. Okay, so now what are the tools that I can use to apply my relationship marketing strategy? Of course, we have all heard about loyalty programs, club memberships, which are given to customers extra miles in aviation, or hotels VIP status, or premium customer status. All these tools were used to keep the customer loyal to the brand. And they are, of course, clear examples of the strategy that we use to apply our relationship marketing tools. In the meantime, the best practice in relationship marketing so far is to engage your customer through social media. Have more engaged customers who are giving their feedbacks about your products on the social media, and they are actively interacting with the brand. There are two excellent examples we can mention here in our session. The first one is what have Boeing, of course the plane maker, has done in engaging its customer in the design process of the seats. So every customer should express how he can feel more suitable on a certain seat on a plane. The second one is IKEA, of course, the furniture manufacturer, a very famous Swedish manufacturer. IKEA actually is working on engaging the customer in the design of their kitchen themselves. You can log into IKEA website. You can use a program called 3D matching, where you can match a model and change and alter the components and the design of your kitchen. So the marketing in this case has become more personal. Repeat again as a conclusion that engaging the customer is a successful approach to success in your relationship marketing through engaging your customers more and more to guarantee long-time relationship.